Hey, it's 8:32. Well, we told back to yesterday all the commotion surrounding a photo of Khloe Kardashian that came out over the weekend without her permission. So there's the pic right there at the center of the controversy. It shows Khloe standing by a pool, obviously. This is in Palm Springs, California, in her bikini. And it looks like the photo is untouched. Yeah, it's untouched. With no edits or airbrushing or filters, her team, her management team, quickly acted to have the photo removed from the internet, even threatening to sue.
Khloe spoke out about the photo with the post on Instagram. She shared unedited photos of herself and a video of herself, and she also released a statement about it, and she wrote that she struggled with body image her whole life, and when someone takes an unflattering photo and shares it with the world, she says you should have every right to ask for it not to be shared, regardless of who you are. So many people are wondering, well, we can all relate to having a photo posted of us that we didn't approve of or, you know, that you wish wasn't up there. How can the average person get pictures taken down that were posted without your permission? And can you? Or do you have to have all the money and access?
Hey, Lisa.
So, yes, we have attorney Lisa Garber here joining us now. Good morning.
Good morning, Mike and Alex.
Good morning. So is it possible then, if someone posts a photo of you and you're like, I don't want this up there, can you get it taken down?
It's happened to all of us, right? And just to get back to some legal basics, so even if you don't want somebody to take a photo of you, or if they post it of you and you're unhappy for whatever reason, you might not have any recourse. So if someone's taking a photo of you in a public place, like Rittenhouse Square or at a university party, they're allowed to do so without your permission, unless it's somewhere that you have an expectation of privacy, like a restroom or a locker room. If it's at your own house, on your private property, or at your apartment, that's a different story. They're not permitted. But still, as a regular Joe, you might have to use a lawyer to help you fight that battle.
Well, what wouldn't be that first step? Like, say, if I contacted you, where do we start?
The first place to go would be figure out if you own the copyright of the photograph. So in Khloe Kardashian's case, her legal team is saying she owns the copyright, and therefore she has a claim under the Digital Millennium Copyright Act. So the DMCA is actually something that social media platforms take very seriously. They have a process, each one does, that you can file a complaint, file a claim, and then they'll go through steps with you to determine if they should take it down. In Khloe's case, it's very difficult for her now because there's so much publicity around her and around this controversy. So really, she's going to be playing an epic game of whack-a-mole.
Yeah, that's what it seems like. Yeah. And because once you put something on the internet, I feel like it's never fully deleted anyway.
No, screen grabs and everything else.
It's tough. I mean, for a regular citizen who's not in the public eye all of the time, there are certain measures for legal strategies. So we think about invasion of privacy, defamation, if it's used for a commercial purpose where somebody's making money off it and you're not profiting or you didn't give your permission. Those are different avenues. But remember, it's so expensive to file a lawsuit. So first you just want to ask, hey, can you take this down?
Yeah. Okay. Hey. You have any more?
No, that's...
Okay, Lisa, thank you. And by the
thank
way,
you.
How often do you get... people ever say you look like Kimberly Guilfoyle?
I've heard that.
No?
What did she say?
I have.
I was going to say. Yeah.
I have. We've never been in the same room together, but we are not the same person.
I know that for sure. Thank you, Lisa.
Thank you.